records later, still I got the game locked. Cut my lines fresher than Tory Lanez pop. Who got his swerve in his vest in every raindrop? Hit it. I got diamonds in my sock. Might be funny like I'm Biggie, but I'm riding like I'm Pop. I'm the king of your city, give a f*** about your block.
Lights on, lights off. Go on, twerk it if you know that it's off. Deep dive and I get lost. Go on, turn up if you know that you the boss.
Used to have a silver tooth and I was just a pup, yeah. Now I got some killers who got shotties with the pumps. I don't wanna catch the feelings, I be trying to see what's up. Got a shorty clean the penis, I'm a diamond and the run it back. Used to have a silver tooth but I was just a pup. Now I got some killers who got shotties with the pups. I don't wanna catch the feelings, I be trying to see what's up. Got a shorty clean the penis, I'm a diamond and the rough.
Old club selling out of here to doing stadiums. Gold diggers don't come around, they don't survive my radius. I keep it too real for real, and that's that made me rich. That's what made me rich. Hustling, that's what made me rich.
Yeah, old club selling out of here to doing stadiums. Small business don't come around, they don't survive my radius. All I talk about, and that's what really made me rich. Hustling, that's what made me rich. That's what made me rich. The whole club.
White, they be shooting in the eyes. I'm sleeping good at night. See the door don't got no locks. To be spiteful, she best friends with the ops. And did you need better stocks. Standing on my money, dog. Please don't get involved. Ain't nobody running off. Rules to the basics. I can't be no son-in-law. I can't take the summer off. I make it look good and all, but this is no vacation. All the goons, they respect me. Advice, please don't try to be rough. Let me know they
old club selling out of here to doing stadiums. Gold diggers don't come around, they don't survive my radius. I keep it too real for real, and that's what made me rich. That's what made me rich. Hustling, that's what made me rich.
Yeah, old club selling out of here to doing stadiums. Small business don't come around, they don't survive my radius. All I talk about, and that's what really made me rich. Hustling, that's what made me rich. That's what made me rich. The
never
whole club.
Had a man. Only watch Scarface. I met her at a club. She twerk better when her heart breaks. Hey, hood, the one-on-one and everything that I can. I'm praying for a Bentley and to never go to jail. I'm fresh up out the gutter, I don't know if you can tell. I'm hustling for everything I do for legacy. You can call me any type of day, my dog, I never sleep. The only rule I got is if we don't embarrass me. I write down my problems, then record it just for therapy, just for clarity.
Old club selling out of here to doing stadiums. Gold diggers don't come around, they don't survive my radius. I keep it too real for real, and that's what made me rich. That's what made me rich. Hustling, that's what made me rich.
Yeah, old club selling out of here to doing stadiums. Small business don't come around, they don't survive my radius. All I talk about, and that's what really made me rich. Hustling, that's what made me rich. That's what made me rich. The whole club.
She from Nola, she got superstition. I'm not waiting and hoping and wishing. I'm not stopping, I'm balling relentless. I'm a stepper, I'm standing on business. And the rumors, I'm minding my business. I'm a tutor, teach you how to get it. I tap in with the ones in your city. We make movies, we all the way with it.
Point them out, 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 point them out. Watch them panic. Got two chains on, I'm too late. Got one watch on my wrist. I'm riding round and I'm getting it. I'm young, but I ain't ignorant. They keep asking who the hell you think you are.
We are sandwiched between Fort Worth and Dallas, Texas, in Arlington at the luxurious AT&T Stadium. Tonight, we've got a good NFC matchup on tap, as it'll be the Detroit Lions taking on the Dallas Cowboys. It's a late season Saturday night in Dallas. The Lions, the Cowboys, underway here in Week 17. And he opts to not bring this one out. The first drive will start at the 25. Start things off with a carry by Gibbs here. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That's a good way to start the drive. 17 yards and a first down. CD, always more eyes on these night games, and they started it off nicely there on that run.
Yeah, and you're exactly right. Don't think for a second these players don't know and understand that. They want to impress their peers across the league. They also want to win the ball game. That's the way to get things going.
Hooker on first down. Finds Gibbs on a check down. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. Well, this defense for the Cowboys, they played really well in that win last week against Miami.
And that's not the half of it. They forced 7 turnovers in that game. And I know we always talk about turnovers coming in bunches once you force the first one. But 7? That seems almost impossible, but we watched it happen.
They find some open field here. 40 yards rushing for him now in his first 2 carries of the ball game. First down, Detroit. So from Cowboy territory now, here's 1st and 10 as they're down to the 29-yard line. Going back to Gibbs on 1st down. He'll work his way up the middle for a gain of about 4 on 2nd down.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good 1st down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on 1st down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
From the 25, here's 2nd and 6.
60 Maverick, 60 Maverick. Hey, Crash, Crash is 60. Check, hurt. Check, Mash.
Here's Hooker. And that went to the right side and incomplete. So, CD, this defense, they know that they have to be at their very best when they're taking on a team here that's in the midst of a winning streak that's now stretched over multiple months, not weeks, months.
I think the challenge they put upon themselves is we want to be the guys to end that streak, and what's working in their favor, the winning streak on the other side. Sometimes that carries a burden with it because they feel like they have to play perfectly as well. Let's just go out there and get them is the idea.
And now the 3rd down throw incomplete as well.
Brandon, watching their tape from last week, I saw plenty of plays like we just saw there, forcing incompletions. It was key in their win last week. They're hoping the same thing happens this time out, too.
Patterson's kick is good. And the Lions are going to take a 3-0 lead. Even though they didn't find the end zone, they have to be pretty pleased with how they moved the ball on the ground, because we know that that was one of their big goals in this game.
And that really goes through the entire offense, because when you're running the ball effectively, just about everyone's involved. It's not just the guy carrying the football. It's everyone blocking for him, both inside and on the perimeter.
And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. And 10 right at the 30. So the drive's going to start with Pollard. Oh, he's got a little daylight. good for 22 and a first down.
Well, partner, I have to say they caught him in the right defense there. Nickel set, fifth defensive back on the field, and they love to run against that because now you typically get a bigger blocker on a smaller defender.
Yeah, because those DBs like you, they want the interception. They're not as worried about the running play, right?
Not at all. And I still remember being in school, and one of my offensive line teammates used to say, "Boy, I'd love to come downfield and hit you little people."
Good run there. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down. The Cowboys at 7-8 now on the year. They were winners their last time out, so they'll be looking to make it 2 in a row.
And so much about football, partner, comes down to mindset. Being in the right frame of mind, and the best way to get in that good frame of mind, winning. So they come in feeling good. They got the home crowd behind them. I think they're going to be tough to beat in this one.
They'll give him 4 yards there. And 3rd and 1 now. So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down. Trying to run for it with Pollard. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee. And that means 4th down.
They tried their best to pick up that 3rd and 1, but their surge wasn't enough to counteract what came back at them from the defensive side, was it?
Offensive line, especially in the middle, looked like they were on skates a little bit when that one started.
So now we bring up 4th and inches. This will be a critical call.
Field goal would have been a decent length at 55 yards. They keep the kicking unit on the sideline. They're going for it. And boy, that's going to be close. He didn't get much at all there, but he got the first. Looked like they might have held him defensively, but the referee signals it will be a first down.
I think in this situation, all you want to do is make sure your guys are set up front. No one jumps, no penalties. Sometimes you don't even call cadence, just go and pick it up.
Yeah, because it's on them. I mean, the quarterback's job's pretty easy there.
It really is. It's about inches. Just go get it.
So this offense able to convert on 4th, and now a fresh set of downs here, 1st and 10. Running right, it's Pollard. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It was Matt Judon that time who worked his way in to blow that play up.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
A 2nd down throw for Prescott. He finds his man, Pollard. And he'll go down at the 28. It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a 3rd down. He's already proven to be a factor in the running game on this drive. Now he gets involved in the passing game.
I think what we're seeing here is the modern version of workhorse in the NFL, being able to run it and catch it with equal proficiency.
Steps away to his left. And incomplete. He had nowhere to throw, so he just tossed it away. But that brings up 4th.
And that's the knowledge you gain from being in this league for a long time. He's learned the hard way when to give up and fight another down. And that's a smart move to throw it away.
They'll pass up a field goal attempt. It would have been a 45-yarder. Now they'll go for it on 4th. Oh, what was he thinking there? It's easily intercepted. Chauncey Gardner-Johnson with a pick. And he will bring it back. An interception return for a Lions touchdown. Riley Patterson now for the extra point. He's got it, and now it's a 10-0 lead here in the opening quarter. So an early 10-0 lead for them now as they kick it away. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. So, Charles, the season winding down, the playoffs obviously not in their futures. They look ahead to the offseason. What spots do they maybe need to fill?
Well, I think that they like the guy who's calling the plays and throwing the ball. I think that he's a pretty good player. Need some help, I think, on the perimeter, though. Help him out with receivers, because I think if he gets an upgrade there, his play gets that much better, too.
Here's second and 10. Off the play fake, Prescott. Throw is caught by Schoonmaker. And he'll be out of bounds right at the 40. Well, every lineman knows the rule. You only get a one-yard buffer beyond that line of scrimmage, and then the flag is thrown, and he got tagged for it there. Play action now, Prescott. And the Lions pressure too strong. Down he goes. They'll wind up losing 10 on the sack, and it'll lead to a third and long. They were able to win last week despite him being sacked four times. They might need to tighten the reins a little bit, or this one may not end in another victory.
You're right about that. They can't count on just winning the game no matter what happens. They can't let the accumulation of hits and harassment in the pocket get to their quarterback. Got to stop that. Give him clean lanes to throw the football in order to have a better chance to win again this week.
And the Cowboys going to bring on Brian Anger to punt on fourth down. Here's Williams to return. And when it's said and done, it's a 58-yard punt, and the Lions will take over.
Let's go now.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. They're looking sharp, out early to a 10-zip lead, and looking for more as they've got it first and 10. A throw left side to start out. That's complete, and he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. The catch and run there, good for 16 and a first.
So many times in my career, I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing, but as long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
10-0 the score after one on EA Sports. The Lions with the football here to begin the second quarter, as they've got it with a second and one coming up.
Come on, check, bobcat, ready.
Out of the gun, they'll give to Gibbs. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. 68 yards for him on the ground so far tonight, as he has been terrific in this first half. Pretty explosive run on that inside handoff, and when you're a runner of his caliber, you don't need a big crease.
You really don't, but also what we're seeing is an offensive line that's taking charge at the point of attack, aren't we? Not only are they controlling the initial contact, they're actually utilizing what they call the strain the next 2 to 3 seconds to continue to move people.
And I think the ball's out, but this will fortunately wind up out of bounds. Thankfully for the offense, a fortuitous bounce there on the fumble goes out of bounds, because they're down here in the red zone. You don't want to lose one there.
You don't want to lose one, and the best part, because it went out of bounds, they retain possession, still have an opportunity to put points on the board.
Second and short now following the fumble. From the gun, Gibbs will get it. And he'll be taken down here at about the 11. It'll be a gain of 2 on the play, but they'll remain a few inches short here with third down looming.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big time play?
Touch him down, but not before he gets the first. 5 yards is the pickup there as that extends this drive. That time the conversion comes courtesy of the RPO.
And know what it did? It moved the sticks. Nice pickup on third down. Even better decision.
Bronco switch. Bronco switch. Go check.
They'll run with Gibbs. And that'll hurt the average a bit, as this time they're able to get him behind the line. It's a loss of four there, bringing up second down.
Definitely an important sequence here for this defense. They've had their share of struggles in this first half. They just cannot afford to give up another touchdown here.
Got it. Ready?
Now from the... Here's Hooker to throw it. And his throw here is incomplete. He's trying to get it to Amon-Ra St. Brown, but now it's third and goal.
Ready, set. Hey, smash, Bronco!
They'll try and run it with Gibbs. Call it no gain on the play, so no help there. And now fourth and goal. This situation in the fourth quarter, you go for it. But here, take the points.
If you go for it here and don't get it, you and I are missing our plane, and we're going to the post-game press conference to hear him justify it. Because the next thing we'll see is the owner walking in, announcing a firing. There is no way he goes for it here. Get the field goal. It's the first half of the game. You've got time to make it up.
And able to get this out to the 25.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. They find themselves down 13-0 here as they try to get things started offensively. First and 10. And he's upended at the 33 following a good pickup of 8.
Now that's the way you want to start a drive. Talk about a tone setter as well as a playbook opener. Now if you want to take a big shot over the top, you're all positioned to do so.
Second down, Pollard again. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. 44 yards now on the ground on just 7 carries.
I'm okay with the call there. In fact, I actually like it. I know they're down a couple of scores, but the running game worked in that situation. I would continue to go in that direction.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Here's Pollard again. And after the good game last play, this time they say, as he's going to be stopped behind the line of scrimmage. Cameron Hayward getting upfield to make the stop.
Sometimes you just sit back and marvel at what he can do defensively. Speed, strength, quickness, he's the whole package. And that package just wrapped up the runner for a loss.
Dak's got this one complete to Pollard. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. The result, only 4 yards there on the play. And third and 8 now. He was out there waving his arms. And when you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention. Because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space. And he found the right spot for the completion.
Now throwing on third down there, but he cannot connect. Normally I'd say this will lead to a punt attempt, but this offense already shown in the first half that they'll go for it on fourth down.
Oh, they should have already said punt it, punt it. Head coach have already made that decision.
On fourth down, here's Brian Anger now to kick this one away. And now a high kick here as they'll try to cover this one. And a fair catch called for and made just outside the 15-yard line. They'll call that a 33-yard punt with no return. And they will take over first and 10.
Okay, great.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. Their drive last time, it stalled out. They were forced to take the short field goal.
And the key phrase, you nailed it, forced to, because you know coaches look at these short field goals as a last resort, right? To them, that's not how drives are supposed to end. You're supposed to put 6 on the board. That's a consolation prize. Like going to the county fair, you don't get the big stuffed animal on that one, do you?
No, you don't go top shelf. That's bottom shelf material. From the 34 now, here's first and 10.
Ready.
Straight ahead with Gibbs here. And he'll get this up to about the 40. They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Second down, and they go back to Gibbs. And he'll be taken down after a short gain as that takes us to the two-minute warning. A three-yard pickup on second and four. Now they'll need to convert here on third and a little more than a yard. Taken in by his big tight end down the left sideline, and he's got it all the way down to the 12-yard line. A big play there for Detroit, 45 yards.
First down, Lions.
So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10.
Kevin Pirate.
Hooker. And this one incomplete. Threw it down at the feet of his receiver. He released that awkwardly. It almost looked like a pitcher who gripped his fastball a little too hard and let it go late, and it bounced in front of the plate.
Yeah, one of those fastballs that ends up at 57 feet, not 60 feet, 6 inches. Just a little short with the arm, which is unusual because we saw him in warm-ups. He's got a big, strong arm when he delivers it with confidence.
Here we go. Jack.
Now a second and 10. Hooker's going to throw it. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by Malik Hooker. And the Cowboys are going to take possession here. It's a touchback, and they'll take over at the 20-yard line.
Absolutely a golden opportunity missed there to add to their lead and really cap off an impressive drive because they've got the advantage and plenty of time to add to it. But on the flip side, plenty of time for an opposing comeback as well. So when you have the chance to distance yourself not just so early, partner, you know you don't want to let it slip away.
And the drive starts with a completion left side. And he's going to get 7 out of this before being taken down at the 27. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. Flushed out right. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away. And now it's third.
Well, this defense is going to have to finish the job. There's still a second half that they have to play. But so far, an absolute total effort. They've disrupted the passing game, stressed the pocket for the quarterback. They forced him into Aaron.
Oh, and his early struggles continue. Here's another one intercepted. And great field position coming up in the red zone at the 17-yard line. So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. He gets this out wide to Gibbs. And he is out of bounds, but first he gets it inside the 10 to the 7. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And they'll be left with a second and about a foot. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him to football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit. But get him out in the open field into some space. That plays to his strengths the best and keeps him out of it where all the big boys are. You know, make him make someone miss in the open field.
The Lions will use the first of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with 23 seconds to go till halftime.
Back. Set, triple, set, let's go!
Gibbs is not going to get in here as they push him back to the 2-yard line. Back at the 2 now, here's second and goal.
Ready?
Just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. They'll sneak it, Hooker. And now we'll get a late timeout as it comes in the waning moments of quarter number two. So with two ticks left here in the half, on is the field goal unit. Patterson's kick is good, and that will do it for this first half. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. It's the Cowboys who get the football first, and they trail here as well as we resume action in the third quarter. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And right out of the gate, they face what you think could be a pretty important drive.
I would say so. You know, they're down two scores. That's not the end of the world. It wasn't the strongest of first halves, but for them to start clawing back, they've got to start putting more pressure on that defense, start cutting into this deficit.
Prescott now. His throw incomplete.
Well, they certainly aren't letting up today, partner, because they forced big turnovers already, and it's been incredibly tough for them to get yards against, let alone put points up on the board.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Prescott off play action. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Chauncey Gardner-Johnson with a pick. And they will be set up now as he brings this thing all the way back inside the 20. So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. Now Hooker. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
And to put it mildly, this is a tough spot defensively. They have to come right back out and defend their red zone. But how about that good first step towards forcing them to settle for at least 3 points? I think they're also thinking bigger right now. Imagine being able to stop them totally and change the momentum.
Working out of the shotgun, Hooker. That's complete to Peoples-Jones. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3. Coming up here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first. Gibbs will try and pick it up. So no gain on the play. They'll decline the penalty to not give them the down back.
And were you thinking to yourself that maybe they would take the yardage there?
Yeah,
because
possibly.
I was. I definitely was. But as you noted, maybe they're just looking at the downs chart and saying, okay, we're comfortable where we are.
Patterson's kick is good, and that will extend their lead even further. So the interception set him up with terrific field position, but 3 points, the end result.
Yeah, we can make this one pretty simple, partner. You always want to end drives with points, but that's one that you're going to look back on and probably say, we should have done better there.
Kevontae Turpin now to return. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20.
The Cowboys take over 1st and 10 at their own 18-yard line.
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive.
I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get two more possessions.
Here's second and four from the 24. Going to run again here with Pollard. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 61 yards rushing for him now on what was his 10th carry of the ball game.
That was good, tough running right up the middle. And if the defense can't penetrate and make him slow his pace or change direction, that's often the end result.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Pollard going to try the right side. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time and a first down.
A good run there off right tackle in an old-school NFL football. The right side of the offensive line, often known as the nasty side. The left side, usually the technical side. Kind of reminds me of the old Atlanta Falcons 2009-2010. That's how they constructed their offensive line.
They'll go with Pollard here on first down. And he's going to get it across the midfield stripe into Lion territory. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
4 yards on the pickup there as it'll leave him with a third and about four more for a first. In search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down. To throw is Prescott. And this pass broken up. The contact well timed there, and now fourth down.
And there's another stop. One of the league's best defenses is certainly bringing it again this week.
I guess they figure they got to start taking some chances. Here's a big one in this third quarter as he'll go for it on fourth down.
47.
Now Prescott. Forced out to his left. That's to his running back, complete. And now this is going to depend on the spot. And they say he's just short. The Cowboys here unable to convert on fourth down. And the Lions will take over.
Ready.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. They'll start in excellent field position following the INT. Drive starts with a run from Gibbs. And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. And tip your cap to DeMarcus Lawrence. Nice play defensively.
Part of the thinking when you bring in extra tight ends, you're hoping that each of your guys gets those one-on-one blocks and creates a crease for your runner. But the converse is, though, you've got to win those one-on-one blocks. And when you don't, that's the result you end up with.
And that's to Amon-Ra St. Brown. Now he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. That good for 21 yards on the catch and run.
And while we may be looking at the scoreboard, this offense certainly is not, because they're showing no signs of backing down, even with a three-score lead here in the third quarter. I think they keep taking their shots. They've seen blown leads happen throughout this league. They don't want to fall victim to it themselves.
Hooker to throw on first and 10. And that's going to be caught by Peoples-Jones. And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the 5-yard line. It's a gain of 35. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Read option. This is Gibbs. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Detroit. Jahmyr Gibbs with touchdown number 20 on the year as his guys are able to push that lead out a bit further. Extra point by Patterson, up and good, and that will bump the lead up to 26.
check box to kick off for the Lions.
Here are the Lions now as they line up and kick this one away. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line.
At their own 20-yard line.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense.
Well, we haven't exactly been treated to a nail biter in this one, CD, and if they cannot score here, this one's pretty much all but over.
Are you saying that you feel like people are starting to think about getting out of here and maybe beating the traffic in order to get home or to their final destination?
Yeah, I don't think there's a whole lot of reason to hang around, especially if they can't score here.
Yeah, you're right about that, because it has been pretty clear who the better team has been in this one. And in a league that we talk about every game being a one-score game as we go into it, watching this blowout, let's just say it's been unusual.
That was well played there defensively. Two tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave them seven blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through. But that's exactly what happened. A loss.
But that's going to wind up incomplete. But the passing windows are just not there. That's just another example of how great this defense has been all game long.
And that's exactly what a top 10 defense can do. They can really change the game.
Now they're going to fake it from deep in their own territory. And this is incomplete. A huge gamble, and it does not pay off. They fake the punt. It doesn't work out. And now the football is going to go over, already being placed at the 15-yard line.
So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material. Looking to throw, Hooker.
And in for the Lions, touchdown. Jahmyr Gibbs, he scored on the ground and through the air. And the Lions are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Extra point by Patterson, up and good. And the lead grows even larger here in the third quarter. Here are the Lions now as they line up and kick this one away. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive.
Well, we're still in the third quarter, so there's some time to kind of clean this up and make it look more respectable now. A win, that's probably gone out the window, Charles, but I don't know. Do you look at this as a time to just improve and maybe start to look towards the future?
I think you have to find something to play for, something to grasp onto until the clock runs out. But, Brandon, we've been around this game a long time. This is an outlier. You don't get many blowouts like this, no matter how the game looks on paper going in. This one has turned out to be everyone's worst nightmare realized.
And now they're in the hurry up. Now flags fly in, and one of the Cowboys looked like he got going a little early. So the false start certainly doesn't help matters as they'll try again now, third and long. Out of the gun, here's Prescott. And that's complete to Cooks. It'll be a gain of five, and that's going to make it fourth down. The Cowboys will go, Prescott. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. Boy, a real head-scratcher there. And the Lions will get the football back in terrific field position. So first and 10 now from the 30.
Hey, check that. Street. Unlock Lions. Go!
Gibbs straight ahead. And he finds a little bit of room, enough for 4 yards. It'll be second down. All right, so they got that one, Charles, against the center.
And let's remember how difficult it is for the center, because remember, he's got to snap the ball to put the play in motion, and sometimes you got that big guy on your nose, you got sometimes where he's coming at you at an angle. It's a difficult job for him to snap the ball and then execute his block.
So following the failed try on fourth down, we'll change ends and change possession. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Okay, ready? Hey, smash Bronco! Hurt! Ready.
On first and 10, here's Gibbs. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. 13 yards there, offset some of the penalty yardage as it's second down. This second and 4.
Panther streak.
They'll go again with Gibbs. And he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
It carries like that. That's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here, Charles, in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, about that. A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tap those mastodons you have up front and say, guys, keep pounding them. Let's keep the ball, keep their offense on the sidelines, and let's close this one out.
The defensive coordinators love that. You got a cornerback willing to stick his nose in there, come up on run support, and stop that pop pass dead in its tracks.
And partner, one good thing about trying to defend that play, you should see it coming the whole way. You see the receiver coming in motion in your direction. Nice job eluding the blocker, making the play behind the line of scrimmage, but an even better job studying the play before you have to try and defend it in a game.
Ready.
The Lions on third down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This is third and 7. Here's Hooker. That's to the tight end, Laporta. And he's going to get the first down as he covers up after a pretty good shot there. They'll get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues.
And in a lot of ways, that catch is expected. Red zone presence. And that one was realized there. You've got to find your tight end in that situation.
And they'll send Williams in motion right.
On to Gibb. Here's Gibbs.
And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Detroit.
Jahmyr Gibbs. That's his 19th rushing touchdown of the year. And the Lions are on their way to a 13th win on the year as they add on to their lead.
Here are the Lions now as they line up and kick this one away.
And he brings this out past the 20 to the 24.
At their own 24-yard line.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense.
At this point, partner, things looking pretty bleak. They still haven't scored here in the fourth quarter, facing the big deficit. Silver linings, what can they look to do here offensively?
You know, it's funny, I talked about this with a coach in the offseason and kind of had this scenario, like, what feels good to you and what feels good to your team? You're down big. You really have, like, one possession left, and you're trying to put points on the board that don't matter. But do they? And he told me they actually do matter. And in this situation, he's going to try and run the best offense he can run to have at least a little bit of confidence to take away from that game. So right now, they're going to try their best to get something up on the board and not get shut out.
A ball on the 32. It's second and 2.
It'll be a handoff to Pollard. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. They'll get 3 as the drive continues. It's a first down.
Second and 2 is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down. Keep the sticks moving.
What do you think?
They'll run left with Pollard. And he'll get this up to about the 40. A gain of 3 last play. This time they double it and pick up 6.
Well, I think after that run, the defense getting back in the huddle and looking at each other and maybe starting to question their confidence a bit. They gave up a significant run, 6 yards. And now you're saying to yourself, how do we stop them? And do I have enough confidence to make a play?
On second down, it's Pollard. And he tried to bounce it outside, but they'll stop him behind the line. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play, so now third down coming up.
Oh, partner, that play brought back memories. Watching them string it out, letting the runner get all the way to the sideline area, but not letting him get out of bounds. They formed that picket fence and didn't allow him through.
Not only that, got him for a loss as well here. And one of the reasons they lead in the fourth quarter, plays like that.
Yeah, it took a little more time off the clock, making them do it that way, didn't they?
So the false start certainly doesn't help matters as they'll try again now, third and long. Off the play fake, Prescott. And that will be incomplete.
And that's another play that's painted the picture of this game overall. It's been a blowout. It's been continually fueled by big turnovers and stops for one side and an inability to advance the ball from the other.
Here's Brian Anger now. On, we think, to punt, though he's faked it. Now they're going to try this again. It's another fake. And this is caught, and a gamble pays off. They get the first. No reason not to try it there, and they do indeed convert on fourth. And I don't know what the method is to know when to dial up a fake punt, when not to, whatever the method there, it worked for them.
I think you actually did explain it. There is no method. It's just a feel, a sense, and a healthy dose of guts in order to call that play in that situation.
Element of surprise, I guess, right?
Yeah, element of surprise and just a strong belief in, hey, we're going to get it done.
8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They're looking at second down now as they search for a consolation score. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the five all the way to the three. That burst good for 20 and a first down.
Well, that last run makes this a 100-yard night. I've loved the way he's hit the holes. He's been quick, he's been decisive, and he's been a whole lot of fun to watch.
Pollard will get down close to the goal line, but not in, as he'll be marked down at the one.
A pickup of two brings up second and goal.
Now here's Pollard, and he's across for the touchdown. Too little, too late, but he does get in for six.
No wonder you're grinning. You just beat me in our fantasy league.
Indeed I did, my good man. Now the extra point up and good by Aubrey as they make the score just a slight bit more respectable here in the final quarter of play. So after the touchdown, Aubrey now to kick this one away. From the end zone, here comes Williams. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
At their own 22-yard line.
Come on, come on.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive.
Check,
they don't really need the points here, Charles, given what we're looking at on the scoreboard, but they've scored on three consecutive possessions, three consecutive drives, and I'm sure that they would like to keep that streak going here and continuing to pour it on.
And things have gotten that way in the NFL, haven't they, partner? Because in the old days, people would, you know, they'd get off the gas a little bit, right? But now, people continue to accelerate, but we'll see what they decide to do as they come out for this one. But the way that this game has gone, they've got to be awfully happy with their execution overall.
Check, Bobcat, check, Bobcat.
Go. And that one going to be off target and incomplete. The CD, they're up big, but they're still passing it. I mean, this is an offense that's had a lot of success in this game, and it seems like they're just having fun out there.
And it does feel like there's been a shift out there, doesn't it, partner? Listen, if you're up, you can continue to do what you want to do. It's up to the other team to make you change how you do things. They'll continue to throw it around until stopped.
So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a third and six.
Cougar 19, 7 Pirates, 79 Broncos, 60 Mavericks. Big Lion.
Ready. Throwing, Hooker. Throw right side, complete to Williams. And now off to the races, down the right side. Jameson Williams. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly. Extra point try now for Patterson. And this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead.
Lions 46, Cowboys 7.
Here are the Lions now as they line up and kick this one away. Kevontae Turpin now from his end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22.
The Cowboys take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
Here we go. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. Where we stand right now in the fourth quarter, this one pretty much out of reach. And Charles, I know they're going to be disappointed about several things with this ball game, but the self-inflicted wounds, they've had several turnovers. You have to think that's going to be something they're going to discuss heavily in the film session in the coming days.
You're absolutely right about that, partner, because they're going to have to sit in that film room and watch every error that they made and figure out how to not do it in the future. And mentally, I think a lot of the guys are already starting to think about, okay, how do we put this behind us and get better for the next time out? This, they'll use as motivation for the rest of the time that they play to hopefully never be in this type of situation again.
It's up, here we go, bucket off the pick and roll. Champ, gotta go, we don't move, it's scary.
Last time I shed a tear, that when Prince died. Cause if we rockin', then you know we rockin' like it's Slipknot. See, this ain't basketball at halftime, we on Swiss side. She thinks she love me, but she fell in love with my rich side. I got it for less, flip that, then I got on a check. Dispatch, then we go on a race. Switch it up if that for the place. Mix it up, got a lot on my plate. Got the broccoli and cheese with the beef on the side. This ain't no regular steak. No one wrong way, richer than me. This ain't up for debate. You gotta love. Maybach, layback, matte black, just to on your truck. Now I'm in the AMG with the all black tint. They don't know it's me, but they got a little hint. How you worry about it when you can't pay rent? I've been there, Lago and Bowie, I went there. Off of MLK, used to live there. Basketball on the tier, used to win there. Up in the cell at 17, back in jail with no bail at 19. Up the road with the life is at 20. Made my first 100,000 at 23. Now who is he or who is she to speak on my name when you ain't me? Why these talking? I'm overseas. Biggie Smalls, when I move, it was all a dream. Keep on talking and pump me up. Call me lucky, I guess I got dummy luck. Give it a play, and then it is time. Better believe he gon' it up. Hey, he might snitch on YouTube. Say that you was up and put that on YouTube.